Thank you. People that have known you way back from time for a tall nerd. Just adds any realism to the whole situation. You guys are not, oh, hello. I'm total on the line. And if I step off the phone, please catch me. I sweat so bad when I sing. I'm just going to make a blanket apology to the first three rows right now. I'm sorry. Then every time I see something flying out of my mouth, I want him to get me eye contact and figure out exactly what it did. We've got a whole lot of songs, hours of songs we'd like to do for you. I know this is a big hall, and it's kind of maybe hard to hear, maybe hard to see, so you just kind of wiggle or finagle yourself a place where you can see and hear during the course of the evening, okay? And if we start a song that you want to sing, please go ahead. You don't have to know all the words. Just sing as many as you know. Make up your lips, bark, growl, or I don't care. Just join in. Ooh. If you want to stand up, follow to a song, please stand up. If the person behind you can't see, just turn around politely and ask them to stand up too. This past spring, we put a record out called Straight Ahead. We'd like to do one of these songs off that record. So in the case that you hear something that's unfamiliar and you don't have that record, it's either off of that record or else it's really old or it's brand new. We've got a song or two that are going to be on a couple of albums that we're working on right now that we'd like to sing for you. So the unidentified flying songs belong somewhere. Other than that, I guess we'll just sing. All of us here from all over the country, and we've been rehearsing down in Nashville, Tennessee, and probably gonna sing for you. And we're singing because we are excited because we believe that Jesus is who he said he was. So you can walk still right now. This is a song that Betty and I wrote that time for a friend of ours that was kind of having a rough time. It's off of the Straight Ahead record, and it's called Where Do You Hide Your Heart?
Thank you.
I was on the side when you were doing Shut the Door, so I know you can sing. This is... It's so much better when you're sitting there and waiting for people to yell something. And then you've got everybody's attention and you just, you know, kind of like, if anybody wants to yell, watch this one, get in your system. And the reason I asked you to yell then is because yelling is a great way to get yourself warmed up to sing. Because a lot of times when people say, we're going to sing a song, everybody sings so quietly. Think how loud you can yell. Surely you can sing that loud, okay? This is a song, it's a song of praise. The verses are from the Old Testament, and the music goes like this.
Yeah.
This dancer is very shady. You know, we really just want me to make you guys get comfortable. I got five times a week. We get a message from singing for people. And we love it more than anything. I love it so much. There are many nights over the course of a year where I have to get up and sing. It's just been the most hideous day. It happens to everybody. But it's especially hard when we have to get up and sing. Now, today's been a great day. We came out to do a sound check. And I thought, you know, all these seats going all the way up to the top of the room. We've been 7,000 people here, and somebody's been coming here a pretty proud new day. Yeah, it's hideous right here. Maybe it's been a little bit weak, or this might have been just a hideous month, you know, started off okay, and just went. Maybe it's been a gross year. Anyway, what I want to do before we got with Robin in the evening is sing a song to you that I often sing to myself. Before I have to go to the stage, so if this has been your bad day, or your bad week, or your bad month, or maybe your life, please let me sing just a simple little song.
Thank you.
Sometimes just all questions, and I find it hard to answer my own mind. But I woke up just this morning, somehow without a warning, this all just kept on running through my mind. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to Him belong, we are weak, but He is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Oh, yes, Jesus loves me. Oh, yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me, my friends, they tell me. Other morning, I woke up and was singing that to myself. And I thought about all the things that I have grown used to in my life. Songs like Jesus Loves Me. And I was trying to think about all the things that used to be really exciting that have ceased to be exciting. I remember the first time I tied my shoes, I was in the third grade. The youngest of four girls, and they were such an uproar when I finally went to tie my shoes. They were thrilled. It is no big deal for me to tie my shoes now. I do it every day. I don't remember, but I heard my family was thrilled the first time I sat on the big potty. The house came down. You know what? I don't even think about it anymore. First time I didn't wet the bed in the fifth grade, big news. Probably spent the night out without fear of embarrassing yourself, having to tell your friend the dog popped in bed at night. I cannot remember the first time I sang Jesus Loves Me. I'm sure I was somewhere in a crib. My family was thrilled in how families are with a baby most of the time. They do anything, they think it's so cute. The only problem with having the chance and the opportunity to do something over and over is a lot of times you lose the thrill of the simple things. Not the time your shoes is that big a thrill, but sometimes something is really a thrill and you still lose heart because you forget what you're singing or you forget what you're doing. I'd like to do a song that I heard about 2 years ago that brought a whole new life to that old song. I'm going to bring it home.
El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Yom Adonai, age to age, you're still the same, by the power of the name. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Kokan Adonai, I will praise and lift you high. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El
Hebrew line starts again, El Shaddai, God Almighty. And it ends with this verse that's only spoken one time in the Psalms. Er kum kata Adonai. That means I will love you. Literally, I'll have compassion on you, Lord. Change your life. The song can make you understand something you've never understood before, or can open your heart to something your heart has never been open to before. It can be something that you share between a friend, builds a relationship, it can be a way of meeting somebody. There's a song that has changed my life dramatically. I heard it the first time about almost 6 years ago to the day. It was in October, 6 years ago. I was home for my freshman year in college. My first vacation of any freshman year. But I came home and I was looking for songs for an album that I was working on. And I got a cassette tape in the mail from a young songwriter. His name was Gary Chapman. I didn't know anything about Gary, but as I understand it now, he was in a band and had learned to play guitar and decided to write songs. And this was actually the second song he'd ever written. He put it on a cassette tape and mailed it to me, and I heard it, and I just thought, this is the most sensitive guy in the whole world. I pictured this guy with emotions just oozing off into his sleeves. You know, he probably just walked around, bleary-eyed. The song was so sensitive, and without knowing Gary, I built this whole personality around him. About 6 months later, we had put the album out, and we had what's called an album release party. All of you that have records know what that is. Those of you that don't, you haven't missed a thing. It's just it's a party where you play the record that's about to be released and invite anybody that had anything to do with it. So Gary was invited because he'd written the title song. And I was looking for him because I really liked his song, and waiting to say hi, and I was kind of, you know, looking for the guy standing meekly against the wall crying. I was there with my parents and my three older sisters and my boyfriend of several years. And all of a sudden, this guy I walked out today with cowboy boots, kind of a cocky gait, tight Calvin Klein jeans. He said, Amy, I'm Gary Chapman. And I thought, wait a minute, this is not what I had in mind, but oh. I thought I should walk out the door one more time, be crying softly. Tonight, Manager Percy asked me out right in front of everybody, and I thought, how uncouth. Well, I had to say no. I thought it was a bit forward anyway. I went back to South Carolina where I was going to school, and I got a phone call that night. And it was Gary, and he apologized for being so forward. And he said, you know, I'm sorry, I knew you were dating this guy.
She bought it. I couldn't believe it.
Anyway, the years rolled on, a casual friendship began with Gary, and about 2 years later, my brother-in-law was helping me arrange concerts, and he said, Amy, I've got this great idea. There's a young Texan who writes songs, plays guitar, and I thought I'd put him on the road with you. Much parental guidance, you two guys can tour the country this summer and sing, and I thought, wait, let me guess, Gary Chapman. We left that summer, and I thought, oh boy, I've got to spend the whole summer with this nut, and also, I'd gotten about 3 irate phone calls from his almost fiance telling me to keep my hands off. You got it, no problems here. By the end of the summer, geez, sorry, almost fiance, we'd fallen in love. And about 3 years ago, Gary asked me to be his wife, and I'm proud to be Mrs. Gary Chapman. I say all that not because it's a life-changing story for any of you guys, but because I'm sure that there are a lot of young men here tonight that maybe have a girl that's really special to you, or maybe you saw somebody in the lobby that you really thought was cute. I don't have any brothers, but from my experience, I think the best thing to do is go buy yourself a guitar. You only have to write 2 songs. You put that second one on a tape and you put it in the mail to her, you cannot believe the things that can happen. We'd like to do that song for you now. It's a little bit older, and we're a little bit older, but the heart's still the same, and it goes something like this.
Actually, it goes pretty much exactly like this. Were those jeans really that tight? Ready?
Yeah.
Now.
As long as I can have one wish, I pray.
It's a work in front of so many very talented people that can do so many different things. And it would really be my loss and your own if I didn't give you an opportunity to see them do their thing without having to do my thing, without them having to do what you want to try to say. Anyway, so I've asked our whole gang up here to do two or three songs for you. You're going to love it. Would you please welcome the band?
Yeah.
Playing bass and also harmonica. I apologize, Mr. Tom Gimby. Next to Tom, lead guitar band from Houston, Texas, Mr. Jerry McPherson. Next to Jerry, playing guitar and also the musical director of this tour, please welcome Mr. Gary Chapman. Playing percussion, Mr. Tim Marsh. If any of you girls have a pencil, this guy is so far from home and he wants a date so bad. Next to Tim on synthesizers, Phil Christensen. Behind me from Los Angeles on drums, Mr. Keith Edwards. And finally, on acoustic piano and everything else, Mr. Reed Arden.
Thank you.
just wanna, I just wanna. Thank you, Jesus.
There's something I've learned in the last 23 years, and if I could just bend your ear for a minute, I tell you it's this, that everybody, whether it be from a concert stage or from a professional level stage or an athletic arena stage or a high school classroom stage, everybody's preaching something. Everybody's preaching something. And when you talk about God, people automatically associate the word preaching. But people are preaching a lot of things. For some people, it's sexual freedom, and they're trying to convince you that anything you can possibly do physically is fine to do at any point that you wish to do it. Somebody else is preaching, hey, you're number one. At all costs, be number one. Step on people, be number one. A lot of times it's a little more subtle than that. Some people are preaching, reach out, let someone. Some people are preaching, livies, livies, livies. Whether it's a product or a lifestyle, everybody is preaching something. And all of us that inhabit this planet are the targets. And so we spend day after day with ideas and thoughts and products being crammed down our throat. And the only problem with all of that freedom is that sometimes we never realize the important things to choose in our lives. About 9 years ago, I realized that of all the people that had ever walked the earth, of all the important, unbelievably awesome people, the most important one was the one who would never cram himself down my throat, because he alone said, "Amy, I stand at the door and knock. And if you would but open the door, if you just open your heart, I'll come in. And I am the way and the truth, and I am life." Because all of those years that happened before that, I thought, oh, it's me against mom and dad, it's me against my teachers at school, it's them against me. And I finally realized that it's not a matter of flesh and blood, but it's a matter of the powers of principalities and evil that live in this world, and the prize is our souls. And I guess I know that my hope and my prayer for tonight and for your life, everybody that's here from that upper corner to that upper corner to down here in us, is that we wouldn't go through our lives so distracted that we overlook the fact that it's our choice of whether or not we ask Jesus in. Nobody else can do it but you. And nothing else in this life is ever going to compare to a life with Him living in your heart. Yes, we sang all night through our songs and everything else. That's the most wonderful thing in my whole life that I could ever offer you. And if I could put in a capsule and say, "Hey, eat this," I would do it, but it's your life. We each have to make that decision. There's a verse in Proverbs, two verses, I guess, in the fourth chapter. And they say this: keep your direction straight ahead of you, and do not turn to the right, don't turn to the left, but keep your feet from evil, and He will establish all your ways. What a phenomenal thought. But that's our hope for all of us tonight. Thank you so much for letting us sing for you, for worship for us and sing, because we just have one last song. Let us sing with you.
Yeah.
straight ahead.